Hey guys, my name is Dylan, and today I'm going to quickly teach you how to create that realistic looking highlighter effect you saw in the intro without any plugins. So if you have Final Cut, you can create this. We have our text here, and I want to highlight this line. I'll bring a custom generator over our clip, change the color to yellow, but you can change it to whatever highlighter color you'd like, and scale it down so it fits over your words. In order to see where you're placing this, lower the opacity a little bit. I'd suggest making the perimeter a little bit wider and taller than you were thinking of making it, and you will see why in a second. Change the blend mode on this generator to darken. This will allow our text to stand out more. Then go to your effects window, grab the effect crop and feather, and add it to the generator. Here we'll grab the feather slider and drag it to the left. This is why we made the perimeter a little bit bigger. If you need to adjust the size of the highlight more, you can do that. Now we have a realistic looking feathered perimeter for this highlighter. To make this tutorial simpler, I'm only talking about one line of text, but if you have more than one line that you need to highlight, duplicate that edited generator and adjust it to where you'd like. To give this effect a little transition on screen and off screen if you'd like, we'll add a wipe transition, which comes with the software when you purchase it. This little point here adjusts the feathering of the wipe. Since we've already added a feather, and since there wouldn't be much of a feather when you press down when you're about to highlight something, I'll slide this point in. I'll drag out the transition duration so it takes the highlighter effect a little bit longer to finish. To add a little bit more motion to the shot, create a compound clip with the highlighter generator and your text by pressing Option G or right clicking and pressing New Compound Clip. Add a Ken Burns effect by going to Crop, Ken Burns, and adjust the end position to where you like. Add some sound effects, and you're done! If this video helped you out, help me out by pressing the thumbs up button and subscribe to learn more filmmaking tips and Final Cut Pro tutorials. I post at least one new video every week. Enjoy your day!